3D printing is something I pursue as a passion. And Divine Metallurgical Services Private Limited is a 30-year-old firm started by my father. It's a family business. We are into various materials testing and analysis services. Basically, it's an NABL approved laboratory, and we do all sorts of material testing in that laboratory. So 3D printing, usually when I take seminars, the idea is pretty much to have a really very interactive session, but due to the limitations and since we are on webinar, I will pretty much try to keep this session as interesting as possible. Speaking of 3D printing technology, we started the company in 2016. There is a lot of hype about this technology, which is very true to some extent. When you talk about 3D printing, today 3D printing has a lot of different names. The most accepted name by our community is usually called additive manufacturing. So when you talk about different methods as CNC, VMC, and such machining processes, these are called subtractive manufacturing. Whereas 3D printing is called by the name additive manufacturing. So they also call it, additive layer manufacturing. 3D printing is the common term, rapid prototyping, and freedom fabrication. So the idea is pretty much straightforward that, we are working with a lot of resources that are abundant in nature right now. But over the upcoming future periods, what we are observing is that we are slowly and gradually consuming over all the resources that we have. And there will be a point where we will be in the shortage of these resources. So you, while actually making a component out of a big slab of an aluminum using a CNC machine or a VMC machine, usually the original weight of the block is somewhere around, let's say, 3 or 4 kg. And after the machining, it just drops down to maybe 2 kg or maybe 2.5 kg. So there is a lot of materials that are being wasted. So that is the whole idea behind additive manufacturing technology. To be honest, the additive manufacturing technology is in a very, very premature stage. I would not say very premature. It has developed a lot over the period of time, but there's still a lot of milestones to be covered in this technology. So let me brief you about what is additive manufacturing. So basically, additive manufacturing is an appropriate name to describe the technology that builds a 3D object by adding layer upon layer of materials, where the material can be plastic, metal, concrete, or human tissues. So depending on different types of raw material that we are using, it can be called a plastic 3D printing, it can be called a metal 3D printing, it can also be a bio 3D printing, or cement 3D printings are, or concrete 3D printings are also available. So these are all different ways by which you can perform an additive manufacturing process. And speaking of the additive manufacturing process, there are a lot of developments that have already happened, and there are a lot of developments that are still in process. So briefing about additive manufacturing, the idea is, you have like a three-dimensional model on your CAD software. So it can be anything, starting from softwares like SolidWorks, AutoCAD, CADian, or similar kind of software. When you have this 3D model, the idea is to, to take this model, put it in terms of slicer software, and this slicer software eventually makes the slices of this object and lays down layer upon layer, and this is how a solid object is actually created. So in the previous starting phase, I'm going to go with basic introductory session for initial 10-15 minutes, and then we'll eventually move on to some of the very advanced technologies and how they actually work and everything. So over here, you can see a very basic explanation that when you have like a, I hope you can see my mouse cursor, everybody. You can see there is a CAD file. Usually, let's say I'm making a pyramid in AutoCAD. So this AutoCAD will actually give an output in .stl format for this CAD file. Then we have a special slicer softwares such as Cura, Slicer 3D, and all those softwares, which actually makes very, very fine layers of each and every component. And you know, it the more the finer the layers are, the more the finer the resolution is. So let's say agar aap log ek layer 50 micron ka banate hai, so it's a good resolution. But if you make it of 10 micron, it's even better resolution. And the idea is the more the finer the resolution, the more the better will be the surface texture. It will be very, very aesthetically appealing. The finish will be very good. The more the better will be the you know, layer adhesions. There are a lot of advantages of going thin, but there are also disadvantages. That is, it will take more and more time to make that component. So, you know, once we have the slices, then we can definitely proceed to the next phase, that is of the 3D printing, where you actually have like a extruder which melts this material and it makes a layer of one over the another to make that 3D component. And that is how you actually get the final object. So from CAD software, as you can see, from this CAD software to, you know, you're moving to this slice, from that you're making this layers, and then you're making the final object. That is the whole idea behind the 3D printing. So the question is, why 3D printing is used? So the basic idea is, you know, to make something that is not possible by the conventional manufacturing technique. I actually see a request from somebody saying that, can you speak in Hindi? Mereko koi dikkat nahi hai, main Hindi mein baat kar sakta hoon, but I hope everybody is comfortable with that. What I'm doing is, hum log miss kar sakte hai thoda bahut, so pretty much everybody can understand. Speaking of additive manufacturing, hamesha ye concept rehta hai logo ke dimag mein ke, you know, why 3D printing? 3D printing se hi kyun karna hai? Aisa zaruri nahi hai ki humko 3D printing se hi karna hai. Aapko बहुत सारी चीजों को ध्यान में रख के ये डिसाइड करना रहता है कि इसको 3D प्रिंट करना है कि नहीं करना है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टेल यू वेरी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड एंड सिंपल आइडिया. यू नो, पीपल आर राइट नाउ इन दिस कोविड-19 सिचुएशन, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ फेस शील्ड्स अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट दैट कवर्स योर फेस फ्रंट सेक्शन, एंड आई सी अ लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज एक्चुअली 3D प्रिंटिंग देम. बट यू नो, आई सी ऑल्सो पीपल हु आर मेकिंग एन इंजेक्शन मोल्डिंग डाई and making 60,000, 70,000 pieces in a week time, whereas people with the 3D printing are actually 3D printing this shields, which they are able to, in 3 months with it, they are able to manufacture 50,000 or 60,000 pieces. And that too, they have a farms of printer. We are talking, you know, 100 or 200 printers or maybe 300 printers in a room, which are printing all this face shields. So it is sometimes, it does not make any sense to actually jump into the field without taking a conclusive decision that, you know, is this the real method to go with, and is there any viable profit out of it or not? Because obviously, we are Gujarati people. Hum log pehle ye dekhte hai ki kitna paisa bachta hai mera baaki sab side mein. So that is the whole idea behind 3D printing. So if you cannot make it by the traditional or conventional prototyping way, conventional machining se ye nahi ho raha hai, tabhi jaake aap sochoge ki nahi, haan, this is where you really need 3D printing. For example, as you can see over here, there is actually a just a minute. So as you can see over here, there is a video of you know, how the copper component is getting 3D printed. So this is actually a metal 3D printing process which is based on metal injection molding. So out of pure copper, what happens is, you know, let me show you over here. So in like metal injection molding, you have a composite mixture of copper and polymer, which actually lays the layer of the component. And once you actually have the full component ready, after that you dip it in a solution where there is a debinding happening between this polymer and the metal powder. So metal powder uski jagah par hi rehta hai, lekin jo polymer hai wo solution ke andar dissolve ho jata hai. And after that they actually take it to the, you know, sintering furnace. So in the sintering furnace, as you can see, this is a vacuum sintering furnace. So in the vacuum sintering furnace, what happens is the porosity jo is uske andar jo polymers ki jo porosities hoti hai wo khatam ho jati hai, part starts to shrink actually, and the shrinkage is almost 25%, and this is how they are actually able to make a you know, customized heat sink, which was not possible by traditional manufacturing CNC or VMC methods se jo possible nahi hai. Aisi cheez aap machining ke bina, you can make it out of 3D printing. So another thing is, you know, besides complex geometries, you also have, you know, complex structures from the internal. So let's say aapko agar inside pe aapko kuch conformer cooling channels banani hai. So on the right hand side, you know, you have a traditional cooling channel, but on the left hand side, you have a conformer cooling channel, which is only possible with the help of additive manufacturing. So the whole idea is to make a die using this conformer cooling channel. So number of component you can injection mold out of this die increases significantly. So there is an increase of almost 30% or 40% of the production. Aap normal production se 30 se 40 taka zyada production aap log ye method se aap kar sakte ho. So this is the big advantage of it. Another thing is, you know, time saving. So one of the best examples I can give you today is, you know, the Draco engine from the SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, which was actually 3D printed in just 2 days. Can you imagine if you had to go through the traditional route to make a rocket engine? It would take 2 to 3 months, but instead, with the help of additive manufacturing technology, they were able to fabricate this, you know, entire system in just 2 days out of inconel metal. So this is also something that is very important to understand, that if you are going to pursue it, there should be a reason to pursue that. Just say time effective hai, geometrical, how complex it is that it requires this process. This is something that needs to be focused, and this is something that needs to be talked about. Another aspect is, you know, component design optimization. So this is actually one of the bracket that is used in the Boeing airplanes. So on the left hand side, aap jo dekh rahe ho, ye jo aapka jo ye jo component hai, this left hand side first component is the original part that was designed by Boeing to, you know, it's a wing bracket that they use. And it was actually given as a challenge to the engineering community that can you design, can you design this in a very well way that it saves a lot of material, but it still has much higher strength when it is 3D printed. So a student from I think Taiwan or something came up with this you know, model where he was actually able to make a design that was almost 40 times lighter in weight, and almost 25 times higher in the strength. So this is where design optimization also, you know, makes a lot of difference, and which is able to only be achieved by additive manufacturing process.